that's a flag on the play.
Yeah, yeah.
Flag on the play.
Hold up.
That's a flag on the play. Let's go.
Touchdown, I just scored a whole bucket. I just dropped a bag on the tag, ain't nothing. Make them throw a flag when I pass, come through stunning. Call me Ty, girl, and hit the hole, then I ran it. Get money,
let's go.
You ain't trying to get that second flag on the play. Hating from the sideline, a flag on the play. Like Julio with them Falcons, I just made a play. In the red zone, going strong, watch me shake and bake.
Let's go.
I just took off with that rock, just like Tyreek Hill.
Tyreek Hill.
I just count 100 racks, that's a whole field. He don't want no championship, get him out of here. I just got a sack, like I run up in the backfield. I just got a sack, like I ran up on a quarterback. Shake and bake, make a play just like a quarterback. We ain't worrying about no farmers, we ain't staying there. Running off the block, yeah, I'm something like a linebacker. I got juice like a Fanta, how you like it?
How you like it?
I'm on purple, I'm on yellow, like a bike.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League brings us to Gillette Stadium in Foxborough, Mass. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the New York Jets and the New England Patriots. Set to go, Younghoe Koo ready to do the honors. And we are underway in Foxborough. T.J. Logan, and he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there.
He was brought down at
a gain of 3, second down.
A 3-yard pickup brings up 2nd and 7.
A throw out wide by Kaepernick is caught. And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. That's how you draw up the run-pass option right there. You get a chunk play out of it.
And you know quarterbacks love to throw the RPOs because oftentimes they're in-breaking routes, but receivers love it even more. The ball gets to them quickly, allows them to put some moves on in the secondary.
So the big play moves them all the way across midfield to the 40 now for 1st and 10. On 1st down, it's Logan. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be 2nd down.
That was a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
And he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line. 4 yards the pickup, 1st down.
2nd and 1 is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I bet the offensive linemen said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs and let's go get the 1st down. They love being physical.
Ready, ready, ready.
Hogan. And he was able to shed one tackle but could not get away from there.
Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
Something to watch here in week one of the season, tackling. Because you and I both know that in the preseason, a lot of these guys don't play a whole lot. Plus, the intensity and the speed really ratchets up on opening week.
Now left side on the swing pass. And on this one, he'll get to the 15, right at the 15-yard line. 7 yards there and a first down.
First drive of the game. We did see this in practice, didn't we? Because they allowed us to stay and watch and see what their opening script would be, even though we don't know the exact play calls. That looks a lot like what we saw them execute, doesn't it?
It really does. And in practice, it wasn't about a lot of big shots on an opening drive. They wanted to put together a series of plays, sustain it. They've done that. The defense now on their heels a little.
That they are. And you know what else is happening now? They're gaining information. They're gaining knowledge about how the defense is planning on playing them. So not only are they being successful on this drive, they're filing things away for future drives in this game.
On the option, it'll be Kaepernick. He gives it up. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. 5 yards on the carry there, and it leaves him with third and about 6 yards to go.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
Eighth play of this opening drive coming up. This is third down. On play action, it's Kaepernick. They'll roll him out right. This will be caught just inside the 10. And he nearly got the first himself, but it appears he's going to be about a yard or two short. Just a 5-yard pickup, and it leads to fourth down. And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on fourth. Here we go with Michelle, and he's in. Touchdown, Patriots. A 6-yard touchdown run. And the Patriots drive right down the field and score on the opening drive.
CeeDee, that call, it took some guts. It's not like they were at the 1-yard line. They had some distance to go.
They certainly did, and you know, a lot of people might say that's fly by the seat of your pants type of coaching. But it's also sending a message out there. We're going to be unpredictable. You can't prepare for anything with us. You never know which way we're going to go. We zig, you zag.
And now some serious opening drive momentum. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Jets take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Oh, a scrap for the football, and he's going to come down with it. The pass. Successful start to the drive, 17 yards, and moves the sticks.
Defense gives up a touchdown on the opening drive. Offense, you got to want to get out there and get those points back right now.
And that's a sharp throw there to get this drive off to a good start. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. Rookie quarterback, rookie running back. They team up there to pick up the first.
First down.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Some good tackling there as he stopped up at about the 41. Defensively, a solid response after giving up back-to-back first downs.
Brings up second and 8.
The last run good for 2. Here's second and 8. After after one. 7-0. On EA Sports.
Patriots 7. Jets nothing.
Here's 2nd and 8. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's 3rd down.
And that's one of those plays where it's hard to keep two eyes on the football when you know the contact's coming, let alone get two hands around it, hugging it to your body, and absorbing the hit. Even for those big tight ends, who you would think could absorb that contact.
On 3rd down, he'll drop to throw. Yeah, that one's going to be knocked away and incomplete. The veteran Stephon Gilmore able to break that one up.
Has to be a little bit of frustration there. Back-to-back incompletions. Receivers blanketed on both attempts, this time on 3rd down.
And a bit of a mistake there. This is well into the end zone for a touchback.
At their own 20-yard line.
The Pats at the line, ready to go. And that last touchdown drive they had, very balanced. How key is that balance?
It's huge, because most of the time when we talk about balance is running, pass, almost 50-50. But most of the times when you talk to offensive coaches, they say balance is we do what we want when we want to. And that means that they're ahead of the defense, keeping them on their heels.
Yeah, they imposed their will on that last drive. Second and 9 now from the 21.
91. Hey, 91. 91. Check 26. Check 26. Whip, whip. Whip, whip. Hey, 91. 91. Hey. Walk, walk, walk. Get walk.
Kaepernick gonna throw. Flushed out right. And this is incomplete.
Well, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
I'm a real one, so I ain't concerned. I'm fully built for this life. I think I earned all my stripes. I don't believe all the hype. Get back on my feet and get right.
After an incomplete pass on 2nd down, that'll leave him trying to convert on 3rd and 9. Working from the gun, it's Kaepernick. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Logan. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. That goes as a gain of 11 and a Patriot first down.
That's a play that will likely be forgotten when you talk about big moments in this game. But plays like this are critical to keep drives going. And if points result, we'll call this play significant.
From the 32 now, here's 1st and 10. On 1st down, it's Logan. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on 1st down.
That's a really good gain right there. They pick up 5 yards halfway to a 1st down. The only problem now in the huddle, everyone's going to want to touch the football. Be a lot of chattering now because they've seen that they can move the line of scrimmage.
The 1st down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5. The gun, it's Kaepernick. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. 6 yards the pick up, and that's a 1st down.
1st and 10 at the 42-yard line.
Now Cap, he's going to look to run. And he's got room. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. An excellent run of 22 yards on the keeper and also a 1st down.
Red.
Shotgun snap now for Kaepernick. That'll be complete to Cook. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Another good gain. That's now 35 yards combined on those last two plays.
First and 10 at the 23-yard line.
Two minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes, we'll again head down to visit with Jonathan Coachman in Orlando, back for another year. He'll have scores from around the NFL here on this opening weekend. They'll run on first down. Logan, and he takes it down to the 10-yard line. 13-yard gain yet again, just like last play.
Partner, in our years together, we've never really run into a player that's admitted a doubt or a lack of confidence, right? But right now, I'm just wondering about that interior line, because on defense...
And he'll take it into the end zone for a Patriot touchdown. A 10-yard touchdown run. And the Patriots, they add on to their lead.
It's not much as perfect in football, but that's about as close to it as you're going to get. Score, force a punt, score again.
And both drives were impressive. The opening drive was, that last one was. Now on the other side, though, what's your psyche? You're really behind the eight ball.
You got to make sure you just hold in there. Survive the early storm, relax a little bit, and try and get back to your game plan. It's way too early for panic.
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. It hasn't gone particularly well for them, that's obvious. In these conditions, no points so far. They've got to get that offense on track. The question, how do they do it?
It is the age-old question, isn't it? And to me, finding a way to make sure your playmakers touch the ball without it being too exotic. Meaning you don't have to go deep down the field. Maybe hit them on those short passes on the perimeter. Make sure you just turn around and hand it to your best runner. And get out of the way. Don't cause any extra stress on your offense.
Now left side, a completion to his tight end. And not much to speak of. Call it a 1 yard gain up to the 26. They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leaves them with 3rd and 9 looming. This defense tightening up a bit. That last catch, just 1 yard, making it 3rd and 9. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. And some room to roam now. When the rookie QB gets his first touchdown pass, that's one you put in the trophy case. First career interception, that's going to be one he wants to forget.
Yeah, and he's not going to go ask for the football, right? Yeah, you can keep that one. The key for him, what does he learn from it? When he watches the tape, does he have an answer right now where he already understands what mistake he made? That's what the coaches are going to want to know, and that's what they'll grill him on and see how he grows from it.
That goes as a gain of 11 and a Patriot first down. Now the Patriots going to use one of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play in this first half. Now a 1st and 10 at the 11. On 1st down, it's Logan. And here he'll get it down to the 7. Now the Patriots will use the 2nd of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. Following the pickup of 4, here's 2nd and 6. Kaepernick's going to keep it. He pitches it. And he's in. Touchdown, Patriots. T.J. Logan. Already his 2nd touchdown here in this opening weekend. And the Patriots add on to their lead. And it is now 21-0.
Makes the score Patriots 21, Jets nothing.
Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. And they're in an early hole. The first drive, they threw the interception. That led to a touchdown. So, decent-sized deficit early on.
It is, but I think you hit the key words, early on. So, they have to decide, do we even need to change game plan? Or do we just need to execute better and try and get back in this game?
And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. The Jets are going to use the first of their timeouts. As they stop it with 19 seconds to go in half number one. So quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line. They're going to look to throw. Flush to his right. And he will go down outside of the pocket for a sack. Tried to get away but could not. Lightning speed there from the safety Devin McCourty on the sack. So we've reached halftime here on opening weekend. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. We'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. And that first half, one to forget really on both sides of the ball. They got to find some way to string something together here, don't they?
Yeah, they're down big right now. So as you mentioned, trying to find something to string together, get some consistency, something sustained, maybe calm their whole team down and find a way to get back in this one.
Yeah, because right now you're down big, you're being shut out. Let's see if this is the drive that kind of kickstarts them. Second and 15. Forced out to his left. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's third.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable. That's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they've brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that, and they force another incompletion.
And he took the contact as he was throwing it, and the ball drops incomplete.
But the passing windows are just not there, and that's just another example of how great this defense has been all game long.
And that's exactly what a top 10 defense can do. They can really change the game tempo and frustrate you as you try to execute offensively.
So a good punt there, but a nice return of 11 yards. And the Patriots take over.
34-yard line.
New England with a first down as they begin the drive. They were able to get the ball back here, didn't surrender any points. Now they'll look to add to that lead.
And how about the boost the defense gave them? Going right out on the field, shutting them down, not giving up any points, and turning the ball back over. They want to do their part now and show them a little respect and some gratitude by scoring some points.
And to get a little more cushion. They'll run on first down. It's Logan. And he'll take it across midfield down into Jet territory.
He's across midfield.
And give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six.
It's now second and six.
Here's Kaepernick. He'll buy some time right. He'll try and run it. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. Say what you want, but Kaepernick's still one of the best at doing that as the scramble gets him a first.
First and 10 at the 39-yard line.
So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material.
They run with Logan. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and four.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
They run again with Logan, and he's dropped just before the line to gain. Four-yard pickup leaves him with third and one. Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Patriot touchdown. T.J. Logan with now 3 week one touchdowns. And the Patriots add 6 to their lead. And he'll bang that one through.
Makes the score Patriots 28, Jets nothing.
Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
25-yard line.
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive.
These guys had to punt last time. It has not been a very fruitful game offensively thus far. They haven't even made a trip to the red zone.
And I know that everyone's... going crazy on that sideline because that drives you berserk to come off the field, not really move the ball well, as you said, not even get to the red zone, let alone, you know, not even put points on the board. They've got to just take a deep breath, relax, try and figure out what is working and call more of that.
Second and 6. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down.
He's had trouble finding open receivers all game, CD. That's because really there hasn't been many. This defense has been all over
them. Yeah, they're one of the better defenses in the league. And every time I talk to someone around the NFL, they all say the exact same thing. They're so fundamentally sound, it's hard to execute against them.
He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. And he's going to be stopped here a few yards short of the first as the tackle is made at the 33.
It's now fourth down.
Here we go on fourth down. And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first. Give them credit. They knew what they wanted to dial up on fourth. They executed it for 9 yards, and the offense stays out there.
New York.
Right back to him on first down. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
This defense is just flat getting after it. They have not given up much of anything in the run game. Case in point right there.
Here we go on second and 12. He'll rifle this one deep right side. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Stephon Gilmore. And they are going to take over right there at the 22-yard line.
The Patriots.
The Pats at the line, ready to go. And that last drive, it was all about the ground game, ground and pound.
And I don't care how we're playing the game these days, offensive linemen still want to fire out and smack the guy opposite them and move the football on the ground. They feel better about that. That's what they want to do. That's how they want to play, and that's how they got it done.
Yeah, they got it for a touchdown last drive. Let's see what happens here.
That's the end of the third quarter of play with the score Patriots 28, Jets nothing.
First down, Logan, and he takes it past the 45 and down at the 46.
He was tackled at the
5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
Second and five.
Now Kaepernick. And that'll be caught by the tight end, Keene. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
That was a route run not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to one.
On first down, Kaepernick eluding the pressure right. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. Give him 10 that time, escaping the danger, running with it, and picking up a first down.
Kaepernick was looking to throw, but then it became decision time. And when he saw they had room to run, he made the right decision to pull it down there, and he winds up picking up the first down.
A quick throw by Kaepernick, complete. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30. They'll contain him to just four. Second down.
It's now second and six at the 30-yard line.
Hey, 91! 91! Watch out.
Play action. Now Kaepernick sliding out of the pocket. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far. It brings up third down. They need to get this to the 24 on third down. On third down. It's Logan. And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. It's a 6-yard pickup, but still a few chain links short, it appears, with fourth down coming up.
Less than a yard.
The offense here not budging. They're going to fight for it on fourth and inches. On fourth down, here's the option. They get this out quickly to the left side. And he's in. Touchdown, Patriots. A 24-yard touchdown as his guys continue to pour it on. I think all teams probably like seeing that schedule for the first time, looking at week one, oh good, we're at home. This is why you want to be home in week one. They're looking sharp.
And I agree with you totally. That's what you want, but there carries a little extra pressure with that as well, because you and I both know protecting the home field, winning your home games is paramount in this league. So you go into it, yeah, we want it, but now you actually have to go out and prove it.
Yeah, two sides to that coin, and looking like they're going to protect it here in this one. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. And they knew coming in that this would be a tough place to go in and win a season opener. But this has just been a performance. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Sean Davis with a pick. And his guys will take over at the 30-yard line. CD, this defense, I mean, at this rate, they're just having fun out there right now.
And normally with this type of a lead, if you're a starter on defense, you're saying, hey, let the other guys play. But with this going on,
no one wants to come out of the game. They all want their shot at picking off a pass.
And the Jets pressure too much as down he goes. Solomon Thomas, they love to see that from him as he slips in for the sack.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
That's out to the left, flat and complete. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. A good pickup there, 18 yards as they get closer for third down.
And that was yardage that they needed there after the sack on first down. They didn't get all of it back, but now they look at third down as a manageable situation, one that they have a much better chance of picking up.
And he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10. They get the first. The decision to run on third and medium winds up being a good one.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they turn to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
9 yards on the run there, and it will take us to the two-minute warning. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. From the three, second and a yard. Now here's another carry for Harris. And he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the five. He'll lose a yard on the play, so now they need 3 yards on third down.
That's a really alert defense there because they saw the heavy look come in from the offense, countered it with extra linebackers who brought a little bit of speed and heft, and able to really make a big-time play for their defense.
And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down. It'll be called a gain of 2, and that'll leave him with some options here on fourth and inches. Line of scrimmage, the 2. They can still get a first down if they just get a yard out of this on fourth and very short. They'll keep it on the ground. Logan. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. They only got a couple, but a couple's all that they needed as they convert on fourth.
First down and goal to go.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal.
Leads to second and goal.
On second down, it's Logan. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. Now the Patriots going to use one of their timeouts. It's just their first. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages. Third and goal as they look to pour some more salt in the wound. They'll try to run this one in. No gain on the play that time, so a big stop, and it's going to leave them with a fourth and goal. This is a long drive offensively. Wouldn't you hate to end this with just 3 points?
Doesn't it feel like during a ball game you have certain narratives going on and there's certain drives that seem to take on just a bit more importance than others? This feels like one of those, doesn't it? To me, 3 points here, a major letdown. This is the time to go and put 6 on the board.
They run for it with Harris, and he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly.
Well, partner, when a team's up this big, this late in the game, I always wonder what's their motivation, because if it's me, I'm thinking about pulling on the reins a little bit. But for them, I don't think it's in their DNA. It's not their head coach's makeup at all. I think his opinion is, you stop us, we're not supposed to pull back ourselves.
Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. Taken at the 15, a short kick. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25.
26-yard line.
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. And let's face it, this drive is not going to have any bearing on this game, but it's kind of important for one reason, isn't it?
It certainly is. You got to get points. And okay, all right, I'm being facetious here. But you get points, you feel a little bit better about yourself as you move on to the next one.
And you definitely could make the case we might not even be in overtime had he not thrown 3 interceptions in regulation. But looking better here so far in OT.
Yeah, and when you think about what a coach is thinking at that point, because normally you've thrown 3 picks during the game, you might craft your play calling to be a little more careful. Not in this case. The green light still on for him.
So that'll do it for my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry. I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports.